Welcome. This is the first online core class that we're doing for City Sport. My name is Nikki. I normally teach Monday lunchtimes, a hit strength and abs class. So we're kind of doing the abs part of that class. It's going to be roughly half an hour. The only thing you need today is something comfortable to lie down on, either a carpet or a mat. You definitely need to be wearing trainers. And this class isn't suitable for any pregnant ladies, unfortunately, because we do quite a bit lying down on our backs and we have to be careful that we're not trapping the oxygen supply there for the baby. So everybody else, get yourself ready to go. If you have any music, this is a good chance to put your music on, keep you motivated, and we'll begin. So when you're ready, lie down on your backs. Feet are roughly hip distance apart. As you go down, just relax your arms by your side, palms are facing up. You want to press your lower belly down into the floor, and then we'll begin. Slowly, we lift our knees up for two counts, and slowly we tap the toes down. We lift up and we tap down. Now as we lift up, we want to make sure that our knees, they stop once they go in line with the hips, because we're trying to activate the muscles below the belly button. We control the weight of our legs. A lot of things are called core training is our timing precision. And as you're doing so, you're making sure your back stays firmly pressed down into the floor. When you're ready, take your fingertips outside your temples. And on the next count, we're going to change it into a C crunch. So as you lift the knees, lift the chest up, and then slowly down again. Sliding your ribs towards your hips, eyes lift between your knees, and come down. You want to breathe out as you lift the chest, and then breathe in on the way down. So we're just slowly warming up the muscles all the way down the front abdominals. A couple more at this speed. Next time, you're going to ground your feet, just lift the upper chest and quick single crunches. Up, down. It's really important here, have a think where your hands are. They want to be touching just the outside of where your eye sockets are. And you want to make sure your elbows are nice and wide so you cannot see them. It's really tempting with core training to grab onto the neck. What we want to avoid is putting any pressure there. So we want to touch just outside the eye temples instead. Now keeping at this speed, add the C crunch again, lift your knees up, down, and you'll start to feel a nice warm feeling as your muscles are working down the front abdominals. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, take your arms wide, palms are facing up, you want to glue your shoulders down into the floor, lift your knees above your hips. Either you can have your feet at hip distance or you can have your feet touching and your knees slightly wide. We're going to warm up through to our obliques. So slowly drop your knees towards me, keeping your back shoulder pressed down into the floor and then lift up back to centre and then towards the back wall. Again, it's really tempting here to allow the weight of your legs to pull your legs down and lift the shoulder up, and you want to avoid that. So you just want to drop them down just a small amount and then lift up. We're going to do that two more times to make sure the muscles are nice and warm. Coming forward. Lifting up. And then going back. And one more time both ways.
One more. I haven't done that yet.
And finally towards the back. Okay, bring your feet down. We change it to a cross crawl with a toe tap. Front, back, front, back. So again, really being conscious of your elbows. You want to keep them wide. If you can, touch them down to the floor as you twist. And just tap the toes to the floor at the moment because it's only the warm-up. We want to warm up into the side of the muscles too. Begin your shoulder across the body to the opposite knee. 4, 3, 2, 1. And then finally, we warm up into the back muscle. So again, arms by your side, palms up. Walk your feet a little bit closer towards the bum and then keeping your hips square to the ceiling, lift them up, sliding the vertebrae at a time, sucking the abs in tight, squeeze your butt muscles that are tighter and push your heels down into the floor. You're going to lift your front heel, then the back heel, front, back, just activate into the hips a little bit too. In 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly roll yourself down. You should be feeling warm now. Roll yourself onto your stomachs, please. Now take your elbows directly under your shoulders. You want to lift up through your chest. So you're on your knees at the moment, your back is straight, your eyes are looking about a foot in front of you on the floor, and you're sucking your belly in tight. This is our level one for the hover. Now if you've got any lower back pain or anything feels a little bit uncomfortable, stay down on your knees. Otherwise, if you can, push up through the toes and hold here. You're sucking your abs in tight as you're in the full hover pose. We want you to try and focus on pushing your heels backwards, lift up through the thighs, and use your forearms too, lifting up through the chest to stop your shoulders collapsing here. And we're just gonna hold here. So we could do hundreds and hundreds of crunches in this half hour session. They're fun to do, but this is really effective for working 360 degrees of our cores. Okay, now if you're on your toes, I want you to now do a double knee drop. So really gently, you drop your knees down and then you push up back through the heels. You wanna try and not transfer all your weight down to the floor, just a gentle tap here as you do so. If you're on your knees, you have the option of either staying still or you can just extend one leg at a time. And as you do so, really focus on making sure your hips don't lift. They want to stay parallel and flat to the floor. That's it, and a few more of these. So down and up. Two more. One more. Awesome. Come back down to your knees if you're on your toes. Everyone at all times with the plank positions and the hovers, make sure your feet are always planted down on the ground because that gives you stability, just really helps you. If at any time you need a recovery, come into a child's pose and then reset and rejoin us. For those of us who are holding our hovers, we want you to start on your knees, rotating towards me, come into a side hover, keeping your top elbow bent. The focus here is on pulling the elbow behind you and lifting up through the hips here. Slowly come back to centre, holding your hover. And then turning towards the back. Remember, back, bottom knee is down at the moment. You're pulling your elbow behind you. Just keeping up tall. And then you're coming back down and holding. Option if you want is to intensify the movement by coming up onto your toes. Everyone rotate towards the front. That's nice, I think. I'm trusting that you're doing the exercise and not just watching, right? And then come back and hold. And then take it towards the back. As you turn, your shoulders, hips and ankles all move as one. Remember, this is a tough exercise, so it's absolutely fine to come down onto your knees. With core training, if you modify the exercises and you keep your technique strong, you're gonna get much better results than if you just always go for what you think is the most intense level, but then find you're not executing it well. And then again, towards the back. Holding it back in the hover position. Hold still here. We're gonna slowly lift our front leg up. Now you have a choice. If you're on your toes, you lift it a couple of inches only. We don't want to take it really high, we hold it really low. If you're on your knees, it's the same thing. Now by lifting the leg up, we destabilize our trunk muscles because now we've got a contact point less. We've gone from four contact points to just three. And then we place it down and we change legs. So either on your knees or your toes, hold, hold, hold. The leg that's extended, try and point the toes. So again, you're really pushing the muscles away from the trunk and adding intensity here. Change legs, front leg again extends, hold. And remember, use your forearms here, push through the ground, up, open up through the chest, place the leg down, and lift the other leg, hold. You might be shaking, that's fine. Okay, place that foot down, come into a quick child's recovery, stretch yourself out. And then walk your hands directly under your shoulders now. You want to take your knees slightly further away, so your weight is forward. Shoulders need to be higher than your butt, that way your core muscles are loaded up. Either on your knees, or option, up on the toes. Hold it here. That's nice. I hope you have some good music for this, right? It really helps with the motivation. Okay, your front leg is going to come forward to the knee in front, and then back, and then your back leg comes forward too. So keeping your body still, you're loading up through your hip flexors and the lower belly. Your option is on your knees, exactly the same thing. And your knee is just going directly forward. So your right knee comes to your right elbow, left knee to left elbow. Now if you've got any problems with your wrists, this is a good option again on your knees because it just has slightly less body weight from the upper body down to the hands and the wrists area. Okay, keep it going. Four, three, two. I'm going to speed it up, mountain climber, quick as you can. Really good calorie burn of this. Driving your knee towards the chest, look in front. What you want to avoid doing is this, okay? As soon as you do this, you compromise your technique. So keep looking forward. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well done. Come back onto your backs a little bit. I have to say, I'm quite relieved the camera hasn't just collapsed. So I'm one happy on these there. Okay, back on your backs. Knees are bent at 90 degrees. You can lift your heels up if you want to activate into your hip flexors more. New move, we crunch up, we rotate, crunch and down. Center, twist, center, down. The opposite arm reaches outside the knee. And as you lift the arm across, trying to lift the chest a tiny bit higher to really get deep into your muscle fibers. You can stay there or make a C crunch, extending the other leg. So you lift, twist and extend. Keep it going. One more both sides. Lift up, twist, center, down. Awesome team. Right, back to our cross crawl. Singles, we start with a toe tap. Front, back, front, back. So you're twisting, sculpting, shaping the oblique muscles. When you're ready, extend the opposite leg. That just gives you a little bit more intensity. If you don't like that, you can stay with the toe taps here. If you are extending the leg, try and point your toes. The lower you can take the feet towards the ground without touching, the greater the intensity this move has on your abdominal muscles. Four, three, two, double pulse to the front. Two pulses back. Two pulses back. That's it. We've got eight, seven. Come on, you can do this, just keep going. If I can do it in a really hot room here, you can definitely do it yours. And I think that's eight. Hug your knees in quickly. All right, drop your knees towards the front. Extend your bottom arm out to 45 degrees. Bottom is facing up and your legs are bent at 90 degrees. Eyes on the ceiling. We crunch up and down, up and down. Now as you do this, the arm that's extended out on the floor, you can push your body weight into it and that will help you lift up higher. You really want to shrink the area as you crunch up between your bottom rib and the hips, and that's the area you want to feel it as you lift up. Two more after this. And hold the next one up, extend your arm long, pulses. Look down past your hip line. So exactly where your thumb is, that's where your eyes want to be. Crunch, 10, 9, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Awesome team. Now extend your leg straight. You can, if you want, keep your bottom foot leg on the ground for stability, or you can just lift them up slightly. Take your top arm over your head. We've got some Jane Fonda style crunches. So bring your knee and your thigh up towards the elbow. Crunch up, extend, up, extend. And again, you're using your blunt forearm here to help lift you tall. The challenge here is trying not to bring your knee in front of the body as you lift it, but to take it up to the ceiling. We change pace. Up, quick hold. Out, quick hold. Up and out. So in having the pause, we're just making sure we can't go over momentum, but really challenge the body strength here. Two more times. One more time. Lovely. Break down to yourself around the opposite side. We're going to do everything else on the opposite part. So what you should feel is a work here in this part of the body. Now we're going to work it here. So knees are bent 90 degrees. Bottom arm is out, palm faces up. Twist your body so your shoulders facing up towards the ceiling. And we start with some single crunches. Lift up and down and down. I tell you what, I really hope this is on camera, right? Because if it's not, guess who has to do the whole workout again. But next time with the window open, that's for sure. Okay, keep it going. 8, 7, 6. If you can, just try and lift that tiny, tiny bit higher. 2 more. 1 more. Extend the arm forward, look towards your thumb. 16 pulses. Reach, reach, reach. Awesome. Four more. I think it's 2 more, isn't there? I've lost count. It doesn't really matter, does it? That's fine. When you're ready, extend your legs long. Reach your arm up over the top, and we start with our side crunches. Elbow to thigh. Lift up and out. Remember the option, it's leg on the floor or allow it to hover up and down. And if you want, you can smile just because no one can see you. It doesn't matter, right? It's really good to get your exercise in. Up, quick hold, and out. Up, and out. 4 more. 3 more. 2 more. And 1 more. Excellent. I'm going to turn my mat so it's facing towards you. Hopefully, it's still going to be on camera. All right, we're going to start in a box position. So, arms directly under your shoulders, knees hip distance. We're going to work our back strength. Your back is part of your core, so it's really important we strengthen that and work our posture too. You're going to extend your, you're going to mirror me, so your left arm, your right leg, extends forward. Move a bit. Lift your arms up to the ceiling, and then take them out to 45 degrees. Hold it, hold it. Bring it back. Bend the elbow and knee in. And same again. Now you want to be pushing your weight right now into your right hand. You want to make sure your hips and shoulders stay still and square to the floor. And I really encourage you with this, tuck your chin in. Make sure your arm is not dropping down. It needs to stay in line with the shoulders. Take it as wide as you can. You're really going to feel this in the outer thighs, outer hips, and outer glutes. Awesome. 2 more like this on this side. Pushing away. Out. And 1 more time. Nice. All right, I'm not convinced I'm on the camera, so I'm going to get you to stay exactly where you are, but I'm going to turn for the next set. So again, you are in the box position. You're going to change right arm, left leg this time. Extend out. Take it out to 45 degrees. And then bend the knee and arm back in. Away. Just make sure you're breathing all the time as you do this. Quite a nice graceful move, really. Two more times. 1 more time. Right. A few more moves before we focus again back on our backs. Staying in your position. Take your knees a little bit further away. So again, your weight is forward here. You're going to change your plank to a hover position, but you really want to try not lift your hips and twist, okay? You want to keep everything square. So, right arm, elbow to floor, left arm, right hand, left hand. Changing left arm, right arm, lift, and change again, right arm leads. Coming down, and then coming up. Now, if you want the challenge, you can try this on your toes. If you are on your toes, my advice to you, take your feet a little wider because that's going to give you more stability. Suck the belly in tight. Down, down, up, up, changing arms, down, down, up, changing arms. And again, the option again is always down on your knees for this one. So just a few more of these as we do three. 2 more. 1 more. Awesome team. Coming back into your hover position. Cross your arms at 90 degrees. Weight forward either on your knees or on your toes. And you're going to simply roll on the toes of your feet, dropping your hips side to side. Side to side. That is good, right? Keep it going. 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Coming back, lying back down on your backs. One last time, one last set like this. Whew. All right, this time, arms are wide. We're going back to our leg drops to the side. We're going to take a little challenge. We want to intensify it now. The muscles are really nice and warm. So, options, feet hip distance, or you can have your heels touching. Make sure your lower back stays pressed in the floor. Make sure your shoulders stay down and your knees hip distance and directly above your hips. If you're not sure, if you think they're too close to you, just take your hands, push them into position. Slowly drop your legs down towards me and hold. Extend your top leg out, point the toes, lift back to the center, and then reset. Take it towards the back. So only going to drop probably halfway, maybe not even that far, and then lift to center and back again towards the front. Now there's no good you taking your legs really low if your shoulder is starting to lift, okay? So you know your range of movement today. Make sure you stay within that. And you're going to feel the pull of the muscles around the belly button as you do this. Option if you want, intensify by extending both legs, push them away, lift on up to the ceiling, and reset. Dropping down, push away, lift up, and reset. Now I might not have any music, but you may well hear music from my next door neighbour. I might also hear it from my kitchen, where there's music in there, so hopefully it's not distracting to you. Come on up and down. Drop your knees towards the front. We're going to do one more both sides. Lifting up tall and down and then back towards the back. Down and around. Hug your knees in. Roll back to your hover position. We're going to hold our hovers, either knees or toes. And we go. So, suck the abs in really tight. Hold still. Keep on breathing all the time as you do this. Make sure you are looking in front of yourself and underneath. So as soon as you find yourself looking down at the ground underneath where your belly is, that's not good for you. It compromises your positioning. What it tends to do is make you lift your hips up in the air. We don't want that. So what you want you to try and do is just look about a foot ahead of you, have a look down at the ground. Does your carpet need cleaning? If it does, you know what to do straight after this class, right? Hold it, hold it. Keep using your forearms, lift up through the things. If you need a child's recovery, that's fine. Come back as soon as you can and join us. You're nearly there, just hold on a few more moments. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice work, team. So, final things, a few more exercises for our backs before we finish. Again, I'm going to rotate towards you so you can see what's going on, but by all means, stay silent if you like. Now, come onto your stomachs. Super glue your toes to the floor. Super glue your thighs together. That's going to give you some stability in your lower back. Take your hands wide with your thumb facing up to the ceiling. Now, we have choices. If you want to level down a little bit, keep your fingertips down on the ground as you lift the chest up and down. Otherwise, if you have no back pain and you're feeling comfortable, thumbs are to the ceiling. Make sure, rather than looking up, your chin is tucked in, eyes look down to the ground just to support your neck. I'm going to lift the chest up, up and down, up and down. So we're just strengthening into our upper back with this move. Give you demonstrations of options. You can have your fingertips down on the floor, like I said, like this. And ideally, you want to peel your chest up far enough that you get down to the bra line if you're a lady. Otherwise, if you're a guy, just use your imagination with that one. We lift up and we lift down. Two more times. Up and down. Okay, cross your arms. You're gonna allow your head just to relax down a little bit. Point your toes, lift them from the floor, and you're gonna take them swimming. So, legs are straight. It's like you're kind of doing a little swim like this. Your legs are flapping away. You want to squeeze your glute muscles, get your thighs up off the floor, and really now feel this in your hamstrings, your glutes, and your lower back. Option if you want to bring the upper body in, take your arms out to 45 degrees, thumbs face up, and let's wiggle them too as you're doing the exercise. Remember, you're looking down to the floor, you don't want to put any extra pressure on the neck here. 8 seconds, 5 seconds, 3, 2, 1. Take your legs nice and wide. Lift your feet up. Place your heels together. Now, arms are extended in front of you. Chin is tucked in. You're going to lift up your thighs, pushing your heels together, squeezing the glutes, Then lift the upper body up. And then you're keeping your thighs lifted, pull the elbows back and extend forward. Squeezing the shoulder blades together. Take your elbows backwards and round again. The option, you can keep your hands down on the floor if you like that. Otherwise, pull back and round for four, three, two, and one. Nice work. Come into a child's recovery, either facing the front or to the side. Knees are wide, feet are touching. Allow your hands to drop down. Just drop your head down towards the ground. And as you walk your hands further away, feel the stretch running down your arms and through the shoulders. If you can, come onto your stomachs now. Have your arms just hands by the side of your shoulders. Glue your feet to the floor. Lift your chest. Eyes up towards the corners of the room or the ceiling. Feeling that stretch all the way in your back here. Excellent work. Coming into a box position. Hands under shoulders. Knees under hips, arch your back, turn your head towards the thighs. Release that, come back to flat back. And one more time, arch your back, tuck your chin in, look towards your thighs. And reset. Facing the front, however is comfortable, just cross your arms, look down towards the floor. Take your hands wide, stretch wide. I hope you enjoyed that. My name's Nikki. And if you do have any feedback or any requests for next week, my Twitter account is NixKids. Otherwise, we shall see you next time. If you are coming next week, ideally, if you have a light to medium weight, that's great. Otherwise, a water bottle or something that's not valuable, but you're happy to lift up, that's going to help us intensify some of the core work. Have a good week. Bye-bye.